Hello and welcome to Total Football Analysis. In this video, we will explore Nuno's tactics at Wolverhampton. We will particularly look at how Wolves switch between a 3-5-2 and a 3-4-3 to break down their opponents. This analysis is part of the April edition of our magazine. You can find the link to our magazine in the video description below. And if you don't want to miss any of our videos, subscribe to our channel for free. Nuno likes to have a rotation in the squad, often meaning that they switch between a 3-5-2 and a 3-4-3. What both formations do is transition to a 5 at the back when defending. The 3-5-2 will be used when teams like to attack centrally. This is because it enables three midfielders to sit in front of the defense, limiting the space to play in the middle. Then, when attacking, they have players who will operate in between the opponent's defensive lines. Using the example from their draw with Brighton, Leander Dendonca and João Moutinho would push forward, while Ruben Neves would provide the central pivot. The 3-4-3 would then be used when teams like to attack down the sides. This is because the two wingers provide extra support for the wingbacks. At first, we take a closer look at how Wolves defend in a 5-3-2. The first phase of defending happens when the opponents are looking to build an attack. What will happen is that the front two will maintain a high position but stay central. This is to put pressure on the center backs or to apply pressure on a defensive midfielder. The two forwards will move across if the ball is played out wide, but they will move into a position that forces the ball down the line or back. This is because Wolves are trying to stop their opponents from playing through the middle. As the front two are remaining in an advanced position, the midfielders will also maintain a high position. The three central midfielders will remain in the middle and the wingbacks will get tied to the opponent's wide players. If one of the opposing players comes short to pick up the ball, the closest midfielder will apply pressure. In this example, Dendonca applies pressure while both Neves and Moutinho are covering central positions, which forces their opponent to switch the ball out wide. Once the ball has been played out wide, it then enables Wolves to surround the ball with three players. This can happen as the wingback will push up onto the wide player. At the same time, either a midfielder or striker will move into a position to cut down the angle on a pass back, while a midfielder will be in a position to stop the ball from moving inside. The displayed example highlights how Wolves have set up this three-man press. The three-man press is successful as it rushes the ball carrier into a decision, enabling Wolves to win the ball back. Because of the way they are set up to force the opposition wide, it means that Wolves can quickly set up these three-man press, often forcing players into a mistake, enabling them to win the ball back. They will try to do this as much as possible and as high up the pitch as possible. And they can do this with their wingbacks, as they do not sit as deep as a fullback. Nevertheless, if the attacking team has got the ball in the final third, then the 3-5-2 will transition to a flat 5-3-2. This makes Nuno's team compact, and with the three central defenders, it means that there's little space to play through. However, Wolves will still look to use a three-man press to win the ball back. The example shows that Wolves can create their three-man press while still having four players in the box. Because of the defenders' positioning in the box, Wolves are able to stop the cross. When Wolves set up in a 3-4-3, it does slightly change the way they defend. What this system can mean for Wolves is that they sit a little deeper and the formation transitions to a 5-4-1. This means that Wolves set up with two defensive lines. Wolves will often use this formation against teams that like to play out wide and push their fullbacks high. Using the example from their win over Spurs, it shows how they transition to a 5-4-1. As soon as the ball goes out to the fullback, their winger moves out wide. At the same time, Wolves wingback will push up to stop the ball down the line. The ball near center back will then cover the run if the ball does get through. In this example, Wolves cut the pass out. With this formation, they are also able to make it difficult for teams to get down the flanks. The problem Wolves sometimes have with their 3-4-3 formation is that it requires the winger to get back quickly if the ball gets turned over. As the wingers will break forward and be in a more advanced position than the midfield in a 3-5-2, it can mean that the wingback gets caught in a 1-versus-1 situation. Using this example, as their winger is slow to get back, it leaves their wingback in a 1-versus-1 situation. On this occasion, the opponent hesitates on the ball, allowing central midfielder Moutinho to get across to cover and defend the situation. However, it highlights the risk to Wolves. Their defensive setup enables Wolves to counterattack efficiently. The reason they can be so effective is the variation on their counterattacks. When using a 3-5-2, their two strikers can combine centrally. Looking at their third goal against Norwich, Wolves have been able to win the ball back in the middle of the pitch. Because of their advanced position, Dendonca is able to quickly get the ball to the two forwards. In this example, they are running diagonally across each other, dragging the defender with them, which creates space for a through pass. What the 3-4-3 provides is an advantage on the wings. To target the space in behind, the winger will come short, taking the fullback with him, and then play 1-2 with the wingback to get in behind. This is what happens on this occasion, as their winger comes short and is able to play the 1-2 to get in behind. Because of the space created, Wolves have time to pick out a cross, leading to their equaliser against Tottenham. So far, our tactical analysis has illustrated how Wolves can switch between a 3-5-2 and a 3-4-3. This is also reflected in their attacking style, as at times both will merge into each other. This happens as in the 3-5-2, Moutinho will break with a front two, effectively making the formation a narrow 3-4-1-2. This is so Wolves try to break as a 3 to make it harder for teams to defend. To sum up, our tactical analysis has looked at Nuno Espirito Santo's Wolves. The analysis broke down how Wolves can effectively defend and attack for different opponents with a slight adjustment to their formation. If you liked our analysis, give it a thumbs up and also check out the other videos on our channel.